The whole world is faced with this global challenge. I don't think that the world is awake yet.
There are people all over the place who want to be part of solving this crisis and actually creating the future that we all want, which is a healthy, vibrant planet.
One key idea is that we all matter to the solution. We can't sit it out.
Since the genesis of Grounded, we've looked for what needs to be done to address the systemic root of a rapidly changing climate. If we're going to be presenting a problem, we must be equally presenting the solutions.
Problems are always a solution in disguise by definition, and this is the most gnarly, super wicked problem humanity has ever comprehended. So therefore, it is laden with a plethora of brilliant solutions.
Let's talk about solutions. We look at the plastic pollution problem as an untapped innovation and investment opportunity.
I think agriculture, particularly the regenerative mindset, is going to determine whether or not civilization can thrive in a climate-changing world.
Like, if we're going to get this climate change solution where we bend that curve down, we have to get 40% at least of the landscapes absorbing carbon that are managed.
By restoring degraded forests, grasslands, and wetlands, we can absorb as much as 300 gigatons of CO2. These strategies are being integrated together for the first time, proving that we have the solutions to the climate crisis at our fingertips right now.
These treated areas before the fire are incredibly important to the job. One clear choice involves the use of prescribed burning. It's an extremely helpful tool. We used to do about 10 times more of it.
We need carbon negative technologies. What we're doing is we're mineralizing it, just like the Earth does naturally. We started doing this at a San Francisco International Airport, and it's a carbon negative concrete. So if I have a ton of limestone sitting here in front of me that we've made, I've got 440 kilograms of CO2 that's permanently in the structure of the crystal lattice, and it's never coming out.
Conditions today are different than every other condition that has existed in the past for any human. In that, we see opportunity. We see the opportunity to rebuild systems and rebuild infrastructure to address this new world that we live in, and that can be something that we all benefit from together.
EarthPulse is a new digital platform that enables data-driven conservation. You have a dashboard that's continuously updated with the world's best science data coming from NASA, coming in from European Space Agency, coming in from folks on the ground. Basically a dashboard for the planet.
When you want to ask yourself, what can I do? Well, you can start today on this one. Do not waste food. If you're not going to eat it, don't take it.
We're defending our territories by mapping and monitoring our lands, by holding governments and companies accountable and taking them to court, and by empowering women to build alternatives to the destructive industries.
Right now, the global funding community is putting about $350 to $400 billion to work in energy infrastructure. And we know now that that number is about $1.5 trillion. So we are way short.
We have a solution to restore Arctic ice. One way is to find a material that would be safe enough when put on top of young, thin, not very reflective ice, could make it act like more reflective ice. With this sort of reflective treatment, we're finding a profound restoration of Arctic ice. And restoring the Arctic sea ice is a crucial lever on climate change that's achievable right now.
For the first decades of my life, over 80% of our energy came from imported oil and coal. We have now for decades been 100% a clean energy economy. Now, we are celebrating the largest geothermal project in the world.
I'm inspired that there are so many incredibly good people doing good work that matters, and we have to grow it, we have to propagate it, we have to network it, we have to finance it. There's no cleverness in reaction. It's all in proaction.
Hope is the mask of fear. There's no hope without a fear. And what we need to be right now is fearless.